The Canada Research Chair in Quantum Semiconductor presents an introduction on modern optics and quantum mechanics, 3D films and stereoscopy.
How does it really work? Hello everybody! To perceive depth in a scene, the human brain uses many clues. One of those is the change of perspective you get from different point of views. If you move over there and back, you'll see what I mean. You see? The human brain is really amazing. It is capable of doing something similar with your two eyes. Since they don't have the same position on your face, your eyes have a different perspective on the scene you're looking at. With the images from your right and left eyes, your brain can actually reconstruct the depth of the different objects you see. When we want to artificially recreate this effect using a flat screen, we need to fool your brain and create the illusion of depth in a flat image. To do that, each of your eyes would need to perceive only its respective viewpoint. For example, we would need to have your left eye perceive this image and your right eye this image. If we project both images at the same time, the result looks strange, as each of your eyes is seeing both perspectives. But there's a trick to resolve that challenge, and to do it, we need to understand a simple concept about the nature of light. Let's first take a look at a single electron. This electron has a negative electric charge and has an associated electric field surrounding it. If we were to place a positive charge in this field, through it, it will be attracted to the electron and vice versa. When you move a charge, its electric field will also move. In time, this movement can be felt throughout the whole electric field. This movement also generates a magnetic field in a slightly more complicated way. But, for simplicity, we can just keep track of the electric field for now. If you move the charge constantly, you create a displacement wave in the electric and magnetic field. This perturbation wave of the fields is called an electromagnetic wave. Now, let's simplify the electromagnetic wave representation by drawing only the electric field perturbation in time. If you move the charge about a million times per second, you obtain a radio wave. Doing it a billion times per second gives you a microwave. Then, if you're fast enough and have the charge oscillate at about a million of billion times per second, you get an electromagnetic wave perceptible by the human eye, light. In front of the moving charge, the electric field is oscillating in one specific direction, but it could as well oscillate in another. This movement of the light's electric field in time is called polarization. For example, the previous polarizations are called linear polarizations. An interesting case would be produced by a charge quickly rotating around an axis. Along this axis, the resulting movement of the electric field would create a circular polarization. When it is turning counterclockwise, when looking back at the source, it is called right-handed polarization. When turning clockwise, it is called left-handed polarization. What is interesting in a polarization property of light is that you can selectively modify or filter one type, but let another be unaffected. You can also transform one type to another. For example, if we use a thin sheet of a specific material, namely a birefringent material, we can obtain a quarter wave plate. This optical device is going to allow us to transform circularly polarized light into linearly polarized light, and conversely. To illustrate that, a right-handed circular polarization is used as an input. After going through the quarter wave plate, the light will be polarized linearly along the vertical axis, for example. Using the same setup, a left-handed circularly polarized light will also be transformed to linearly polarized light, but along the horizontal axis this time. Another interesting optical device is the linear polarizer, a device we can use to filter linearly polarized light. For example, this could be produced by an array of very small conductive wires closely spaced. It works like this. Light with an electric field aligned with the wires will induce movement of the free electrons present in the wires. As such, the energy of the light will be absorbed by the charges. The light won't go through the array. On the other hand, if the field is perpendicular to the wires, the charge can't move or absorb the light's energy. Therefore, the light goes through. Fascinating, isn't it? Now, what would happen if we were to combine all those elements? Well, first, we have a source that emits circularly polarized light. After going through the quarter wave plate, it is transformed and is now linearly polarized. This linear polarization can then pass through one of these linear polarizers, but will be absorbed by the other. The same setup will have the opposite results when using the reverse circular polarizations. These polarizations will only go through the left system, but not the right one. The fun really begins when we have both circular polarizations emitted at the same time. You see that each set allows only one type of polarization through. Now, if you were to take these optical setups and make glasses out of them, each eye would see the images made out with those different types of circular polarization, left-handed in one, right-handed in the other. So, I suspect you know where I'm going with this now, right? Coming back to our previous example, we have two images, one for the left eye and one for the right. Using specialized projection equipment, we circularly polarize the light of both images, having one image composed of the left-handed polarized light and the other with the right-handed polarized light. Of course, both images are projected at the same time. Without glasses, we see both images superposed. Therefore, when you go see a 3D movie, you really see two movies simultaneously, which explains the price. So, as we put our glasses on, they filter the light and preserve only one image for each eye, thus allowing our brain to have the illusion of a 3D scene. And that's just awesome. So that's it, folks. This is how we fool our brain to perceive 3D images from a flat 2D screen. Now, just for fun, try to wear the glasses upside down and see what happens. Can you explain it? Until next time, have fun and take care.